What's up, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls? Welcome to day number 45. It is nice and early today, okay? So it's gonna be really dark out. I don't know how well you're gonna see me. Like last week was pretty dark when I went out early at this time, but today it's even darker. All right, let's get her going here. All right, let's kick us off with a deadly song to get us started on this early morning. Alrighty-roo. Probably the only person in this city blasting music at that time. UCLA, good song. All right, read one of the comments. So we got something to chit-chat about. Someone's asking about my height, age, weight, what I eat, you know, all that stuff. So we're going to get into that. First off, I'm 22 years old. I am about 5'8", like 5'7", and like 4 and 5. Like I'm a couple centimeters off 5'8", okay? But I'm 170 pounds, pretty like well on the dot of 170. Last year around this comp season, I was 168, so about the same weight. And then over the course of the summer when I wasn't on my diet, I was about 176 pounds just because I ate whatever. So I usually sit 170 during comp season, and that's comfortable weight for me to train in and stuff. And they were wondering if my body weight and my build interferes with my training. I would say it would obviously be easier if I were a 5'3", 115 pound athlete, but I feel like there's something to do with my body that if I were to sit at that weight or to sit at a much lower weight and not have any muscle on me, I would 100% get injured. Without a doubt in my mind, I would. Because I used to be this skinny little kid right before COVID, and I used to get injured and stuff all the time, and everything kind of just got hurt all the time because I didn't really have any muscle on me. So I figured maybe if I put on muscle, that build will help me avoid injury. And it surely did. That's exactly what it did. So that's why I put on all that muscle. I don't plan on putting on any more muscle or else I'd be too big. I just wanted to put on muscle so it would kind of build a barrier around my body, keeping me safer and away from injuries and tearing my muscles and keeping me safe in my sport. And it's worked very well for me. So if I had to go back and do it all over again, I would do it the exact same way I did. And during COVID was kind of when I took working out really aggressively because I had nothing else to do, and it created a lot of discipline for me. So that was a huge part of it that I loved. And over the course of COVID, pre-COVID, I weighed about 145, 150 pounds. By the end of COVID, I weighed around 170 to 175 pounds. But over the course of COVID, I was kind of just like bulky. I wasn't really lean. So it was like 175 pounds, looking a little bit chubby. So over the last 3 years, 2.5, 3 years, whatever, I turned all that fat into muscle. I obviously wasn't like fat, but like I just had a bulky build. My body fat percentage was probably at like 17, I don't know, like somewhere high. But now it sits at probably like 8% around there. I'm not really sure. And it's 170 lean, so that's good. Yeah, I think that answers the question for the most part. Well, on that note, we are almost at the gym. We have entered the red zone, the dead zone, the kill zone, no man's land. All right. Let's get to work, shall we? Oh, baby, last night we lived. All right, ladies and gents, another day in the trenches. It's okay, though. We got country music going, so it's good. All right, handstand conditioning. Let's go. Deadly. All right, one bar. All right, other one bar handstand. Nicely done. All right, let's give that another try. Okay, good stuff. 0-2. Okay, this is getting fun. There we go. The first three I just didn't jump up at all, so that's why I didn't make it. Japanese handstand. Let's get it. All right, second set. Hey, mister, won't you sell me a...
Nice. Lots of walking. We love that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's try and go to the Real Vault today.
And I say try because we have to go to it quickly before people show up here. That's kind of why I want to show up early today also, so I could try and do the Real Vault.
All right, let's go.
All right, time for Vault. New camera angle. The Vault's right there instead of from the side. I've been recording my Vault turns for probably 2 or 3 years now, and I've never changed the angle. So maybe this will give me a different perspective of what I'm doing wrong, because the definition of insanity is to do the same thing over and over and expect different results. And I've been recording from the same spot over and over and over, expecting to find something different or a change. So hopefully new angle, new results. Let's get our start here. 2 handsprings and then 5 to 8 layout folds, 2 layout folds. So yeah, deadly. Okay, let's get going. Handspring number 1. Handsprings are just for warm up, okay? So yeah. All right, handspring number 2. First one warms up the run, second one warms up the shoulder. Now it's time for the round off stuff, the Real Vaults. All right, round off number 1. All right, that turn was really good actually. I kind of wish we were recording from the other angle so I could see what I did differently, because it felt very different. The point of this new angle is because I was assuming I would just keep doing the same bullshit I usually do and not make any changes. But I guess I made changes, and now the camera's over here, but I managed to make changes on my first turn, so that's good. Round off number 2. It's different. I don't know if it was better though.
It was good. I just watched you back.
It's probably one of the lowest I've ever placed my hand. I don't know if you can see it in the camera. The hand placement right here, that's where my hand was. It's probably one of the lowest it's ever been, which made me go up higher, straighter, and rotate a little quicker. So everything was better. That's nice.
Cool.
All right, sweet. Round off number 3. Yeah, that was good. Kind of good. First double twist in a long time. Forgot to tell you guys I was doing double twist before I did it. So it wasn't bad. Usually when I go for the double twist, it completely changes everything because my full usually is all right. Then my double twist just shit. So at least it kind of stayed in the middle. Round off number 4. All right, the pop on that one was way better, but my rotation was kind of killed as I popped off. I slouched in instead of like bringing it over. So we're gonna try and go for same height, more rotation, and we're gonna do one more double twist and then we're done. Round off number 5. That was better, but I just almost went into the post over there. That would have hurt. Yeah, I watched back. The turn was better. In the video, it doesn't look like I'm that close to the bars, but when I was doing it, it was close. But yeah, I definitely gotta figure out how to straighten it out. And then me straightening it out more will give me more height, because I'm wasting some of my height going off to the side instead of going up. First time doing doubles in quite a while. As you can tell, the twist part's not really my issue. It's more me actually flipping correctly and getting enough height. Yeah, let's go do, let's go do landings. All right, landings. Time for physio. Same physio as the last few days that we created. First up's the bungee, like this. Open shoulders. As many as you can, till failure. Alright, lateral raises. Heavy weight, lower rep. Alright, go for the beautiful stick stretch. Grab the stick like that. Back the elbow, grab it, stretch it, and then you go up and down for a minute. Oh, good stuff. Okay, now it's the bungee again. I'm not gonna show you the bungee again. It's already boring enough to watch me doing the bungee thing the first time. So we'll do the bungee again, and then next exercise. Alright, next station. Knee up, elbow to knee. Lower down, feel a stretch at the bottom, right, halfway back up slowly, and then the rest up quickly to work your fast twitch muscle. But make sure the first half is done slowly. All Alright, now for the shoulder stretch. Got the 10-pound weight again. We used to use the 5. Yesterday was the first time we used the 10-pound. Just stretch the shoulder all the way back, laying on your back, and then hold it there for a minute. Oh my. The 10-pound is so much harder. Oh, such a good stretch. It hurts so much in the beginning, and then you slowly relax your shoulder and the pain slowly goes away, and you can feel your shoulder like kind of clicking into place. Feels nice. All right, last station. All right, last station. I'm showing you with my good shoulder, because if I show you my bad shoulder, it'll look like this. You won't be able to see it, so. 10 of these bad boys. Just like the knee on the box thing, slow down, stretch, halfway up, slow, and then quick. Try and touch the wall there. Oh yeah, good. Deep burn. Good stuff. We'll do a few more sets of that. I'm not gonna show you a few more sets. I just like to show you guys one set of everything so you guys know that I'm doing it every day. And yeah, I'll see you guys over at the beautiful, everyone's favorite segment of the vlog, B-bar swings. See you there. All right, last thing of the day. B-bars are right there, by the way. 2 sets, one set of 15 swings, second set, 5 pirouettes, 5 swings. We're done. Nice, that's one set down. All right, last set, 5 pirouettes, 5 swing downs. All right, done. It's the end of first training. See you guys in second training. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to second training. Today's B-bars, high-bar, and pommel, and vault. We already did vault, though, and we're on B-bars now. I'm not doing a hang again because of my shoulder, so I'm just doing all my sports stuff again. I don't want to risk it and even try a hang on B-bars, considering only 2 of my skills are hang skills. The other 8 skills don't involve a hang, so we're doing technically half routines, but it's pretty much a full routine just without Peach or Giants. Alright, let's get started. Alright, ladies and gents, I warmed up 1 Stutz and 1 Diamondoff and a back tuck dismount. Let's do this half routine, shall we? Half routine number 1. So fucking bad. Routine number 2.
Nice.
2 down. Half routine numero 3. Deadly. Half a chain of 4. You had me and Sam doing coke in the bathroom. But you like yes now. You like yeah. Alright, since that last half team was pretty good, we're just gonna do a few more dismounts. Oh. 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 Sick.
Oh, man.
I just have to stick one and then we can be done. Yes, we're done. All right, let's go to High Bar. All right, guys, time for High Bar. Yeah, that's it. Let's go to High Bar.
I have to see him on camera, I swear.
I like to play dangerous, you know? Live on the wild side of life.
Oh, that was scary. That was so scary. All right, guys, that was a solid first turn. Almost died on the first Coleman. Yeah, let's keep going with some more dangerous turns. A lot of shenanigans there, that was fun.
Black,
it's either a new SI or a Type R. The Type R's
All right, guys, time for Palm. I done High Bar. My hands are starting to like kind of peel and getting ready to rip. But I wasn't gonna do Palmel, but I got Siri to flip a coin. Tails, I went to Palmel. Heads, I didn't. She said tails, so now we have to do three routines. Two to three routines. Okay, and do one touch, and then we'll go for routine. Routine number one. I know where you at me. With your eyes, tell me who do you see? When you're tasting what he's drinking, are you thinking about me? Coming over tonight. Good stuff.
All right, routine number two. Juicy camera off with Matt. You're moving the camera all over the place. It's wrecking the video. Good. Good. Routine number two. Come on, baby, shoot a smile at me. Midnight selfie on a balcony. A little something from Molly. You're burning a hole in my...
Finish on a good note on two hit Palmel routines. Okay, what's up, guys? I almost forgot to do the outro. I was just about to leave, and I almost forgot the outro. Day 45, ran the outro, that would have been bad. Okay, so that's the end of training. It's my bar, did some P bars, did some Palmel routines. All in all, pretty good. Didn't do an insane amount of turns, but everything was not bad. The beginning of P bars was not great. Last half routine was good. High bar was all right, and two for two on Palmel. Yeah, stupid Siri had to pick tails instead of heads. But you know what? We hit two routines, that's okay. Yeah, if you watched the full video and you enjoyed it, glad to hear that. If you watched the full video, comment the word can. C-A-N, can. Okay, that's the end of the video. Bye, love you.